Okay, welcome. I just want to do a little more urgent taping, if you can stand it. And of course you can stand it, because now is the time where you have to make a stand. The responsibility of everyone now is to take their best refuge from the turmoil. Okay, that's our responsibility here, is to take refuge from the turmoil in the best way you can, the best way possible. That's it. No one is responsible to put their attention onto the turmoil. Nobody. This turmoil is designed to agitate your mind and pull your mind into confusion and agitation. It's designed that way on purpose. Why do I say that? How is it that I was aware of this coming turmoil 60 years ago in advance, and others 2,000 years in advance, for Jesus, for instance? Because it's all by design. There's a blueprint for this. And so we have been aware of what this blueprint is, and so we can warn more and more and say, hey, you know, there's this blueprint, this design that's going to work out. So it's intentional. It's a trap. It's a trap. Nobody is responsible from the standpoint of the grace of God. No one's responsible to pay attention to this turmoil. Our responsibility is to not pay attention to it. Ignore it. Take refuge from it in the best way possible. That is the most helpful stance possible to take, because this is all a trap to pull us down into confusion, into materialism, into slavery, because we'll lose sight of our options. The point of turmoil, mental agitation, mental disturbance, is to get us to lose sight of our real options and to try to choose between two false options that's the same, two different labels for the same thing. And that's a mental trap. That when we get trapped into that trap, it's like we're caged. You see the donkey tethered to this little chair or something where the doggy can move easily, but the donkey thinks that it's tethered, it can't move. So when they take a label for a rock and we call it, you know, it's a rock A, and then we say, no, that's a rock B or something, or call it whatever, different label, Rocky. One's rock and rocky. Should we call it rock or rocky? And we're arguing between rock or rocky. And we think that the choice between the two has some difference to it for us. It's the same rock. It's the same rock. So we're arguing over labels, right? And we lose sight of what our options really are. We choose between mental disturbance and no mental disturbance. That's the choice. We don't choose whether to put a dress on mental disturbance or pants on the mental disturbance, okay? That is designed to trick us from recognizing what our option really is. I call it the hangman's choice. You want to hang with a, you know, hood or no hood? And I say, no, that's not the option. Either way, it's hanging. The option is either hanging or no hanging, you see? So the turmoil is designed to get us to not see this very clear, obvious trick and not recognize our option of what? Freedom. Freedom from turmoil. Right? Absolute freedom. Intrinsic freedom. Intrinsic freedom without us doing anything. Recognize our intrinsic freedom. That non-causal intrinsic freedom is what we really are. And this is so. Again, our responsibility right now is to take refuge from the turmoil and ignore it the best we can. Take the best refuge we can. Now, everybody will have different ways of taking refuge because people have prepared differently. Some have prepared better than others. And some have prepared worse than others, too. And some think that watching it all on television, that's refuge from it. Well, I'm not there, but I'm immersed in it, you know. Good luck with that. Right? That's the best refuge they could take. Well, at least I'm not, you know, rioting with the rioters, and yet I'm the camera person's right in the midst of it, and it feels like I am. And is that refuge? Is that the best refuge? Well, you know, you be the judge of that, right? I would say, for me, I could find a better refuge than that, because it's our responsibility to take the best refuge we can from this turmoil. The best. Not choosing between, well, what type of turmoil, what type of agitation, how am I going to label the agitation, you know, as if that's our responsibility. That's not our responsibility. That's being irresponsible, unnatural, very unnatural. And nor are we supposed to spend our time making those who have really bad habits happy with their bad habits. That's not our responsibility. They're responsible for taking refuge from their bad habits, okay? Just as we are responsible for taking refuge from our bad habits, from the turmoil. They're responsible for their refuge from turmoil. We're responsible for our refuge turmoil. If what they do doesn't make them happy, then they better work on taking better refuge, right? Instead of trying to enslave us to serve them and make their creature comforts all comfortable. Say, yeah, I'm going to immerse myself in agitation, but your job is to make me feel happy with that. That's not our job. That's an unnatural request, totally unnatural request. That itself is blindness to what our options are, actually. So in a nutshell, that's it. It's time to take our best refuge from the turmoil. So this is what we're easing into right now. We're easing into it. I'm getting a lot of help. I'm sure you are too. And we just have to, every day we have to be determined that we are going to ease into this, you know, our best refuge from the turmoil. So I've already taken a lot of great steps. I have a lot of good habits. I'm able to just completely ignore it. Almost completely. I mean, I speak about a little bit fringe, at least we'd say, yeah, there's some sort of turmoil. I don't know what exactly is going on. I really don't. But I know the blueprint, so it doesn't really matter. I know the blueprint is for extreme global turmoil. It's by design. It's unfolding exactly as I was warned about. So there's no reason for me to look at it and say, gee, is it happening? Is it happening? Of course it's happening. Of course it's happening. All the players are on the stage, and it's not good. Only a fool would keep peeking at it and say, gee, let me monitor it to see. But of course, no need to monitor it all. Obviously, there's already a lot of turmoil. So take refuge from whatever turmoil there is. Put yourself in a situation where you are at peace, you know, your best refuge from it, your best refuge from it, whatever that may be. And we should, you know, all really, really understand that this is now our God-given responsibility. And anyone who says it's not or tries to fudge on this, they're making unnatural requests. And I don't care whether they're wearing pants or whether they're wearing a dress. They're making unnatural requests of us. And we are under zero obligation to fulfill such an unnatural request, because that would be sitting against God, going against God's will for us, which is to take refuge from this turmoil. Okay, so it's really simple. Just ask God. We just ask you to... Grace of God, we ask you to ease us into the best refuge you have for us from this turmoil. Immediately. Okay, we're keeping it a little short here. I have other videos coming. You'll be able to have video, but here you'll be able, what I'm doing is I'm giving you the option to ease into turning away from the turmoil of the world and distraction. And I might make a little turmoil, like with the ocean and stuff, but I do it in slow motion in a beautiful way, and it says, oh, so that your mind says, oh, I'm seeing a symbol of turmoil, but it's smoothed out and beautiful. So this helps, you see, segue, ease us out of the turmoil, because we're so addicted to it, we're so habituated to it, we think, well, I'm responsible for it, that we don't want to quite let go of it. But this provides sort of like an intermediate step to let go of it and turn away from it. So I don't need to watch all the rioters, you know, here, because I can watch this foam spreading out on the beach and stuff, and listen to the music and say, oh, it's so beautiful. There's a little bit of turmoil here, so, you know, so I feel at least I'm in my comfort zone a little bit, but also it's very serene and beautiful. See, it's art, creativity with a spiritual purpose here to help us with our responsibility. So aim for that. And just trust it and just pray and say, God, you will show me the way and it will happen for me. Okay? Just do it.